phone here, then the camera's turned on. Why is the camera turned? We're filming right now? But I wasn't ready. I mean, I haven't even shaved yet. Hey there, ghouls. Hey, welcome back to Baron Van Gorstein's movie Crypt. Sorry about my outward appearance. I thought I had another hour or so before we started to film. But hey, welcome back. I'm happy to be here, a little surprised. But hey, I'm happy to be here. And, you know, we've been gone for not that long of a time, about a month. But hey, this is a new season, and I tell you, it's going to be a great one. In fact, to prove it, tonight's feature film is from famed director Peter Jackson, from the man who directed the Lord of the Rings trilogy and the great horror movie, horror comedy movie starring Michael J. Fox, The Frighteners. This movie, however, is called Bad Taste. And you'll see why it's called Bad Taste by the end of the film. But, you know, I'm so excited to be here. I'm all clumped here or something. So, hey, no more lollygagging around. Go ahead. If you're ready, I'm ready. Cameraman, if you're ready, please roll the movie Bad Taste. Did we add smoke or fog or something?
Emergency. What service did you require, please?
Oh, quick! Anybody, just get help!
Where are you calling from, sir?
My horror! Boombox! There's this roaring noise! A big white light in the sky! And then these invaders started killing us!
Hold on, sir. I'll connect you with the Department of Internal Affairs.
No time! They're after me!
Hello? Is there anybody there?
What do you think, Minister?
Call a full-scale invasion alert, sir. I'll phone the forces. Fighters, frigates, foot sloggers.
Perhaps that could all be a bit showy. I think this is a job for real men.
Just stop right there. Stop.
Think you'd better kill him, Perry?
Geez, he could be Ministry of Works or something.
Nah, he's moving too fast.
This is definitely your last chance.
Oh. if I'm not the poor bastard that's got to clean that up. Jesus.
The bits of brain in a plastic bag, Barry.
We'll need them for analysis.
No bloody way, mate. You can come down here and do that yourself. You're the gung-ho scientist.
Oh, all right. I'll be down straight after lunch, but at least take a blood sample.
No need. I'll just wring my strides out. Oh, well, at least we got one live specimen.
Yeah.
Seen anyone else about, Barry?
No. The place is completely deserted. They're probably all dead. That's at least 75 people.
Jeez. I just hope we're in time to save the world.
Well,
I just hope you got it right this time.
No doubt about it, Barry.
I've been watching the skies. And do you know what the skies did?
They pointed
at this place.
Friendly.
There's no glowing fingers on these bastards. We've got a bunch of extraterrestrial psychopaths on our hands. Like a visit from a planet full of Charlie Mansons. They've wiped out a small town for starters. It's my guess they'll go on to something bigger next time. Christchurch? Wellington?
Auckland?
Yeah, well, that wouldn't be so bad.
Better contact the others, Derek.
They should be in range now. And you'd better tell them to keep an eye out for someone who could be heading this way.
Who?
A collector.
There's some appeal on. There's envelopes stuck on all the doors, and today's collection day.
Something that's just occurred to me too, mate.
What's that?
That joker you topped a while back. He might have friends.
Keep me asking if I were you.
You needn't worry. I'm not stupid, thanks.
Boys, are you there?
gas elevator music for headbangers.
Rick, Ozzy, are you there?
Yeah, we're here, mate. But could you use a proper call sign? There could be people listening.
There's nobody for miles, Frank. Besides, I don't think whispering's gonna help.
He's got a point there, Frank.
What do you mean nobody could bloody mile? I thought you were in Kai Horror.
I am in Kai Horror. I was right all along. They've done the entire town.
Who's done the town?
The extraterrestrial low-lifers.
And guess what?
We've caught one of our bastards.
Me and Barry caught him looming over the hills this morning, just like he owned the bloody place.
Huh?
Now do you believe me? Jeez, look, dear, just keep him there. You got him secured?
Bloody oath.
Right, now don't touch him. We'll be there in 45 minutes. And look, whatever you do, don't harm him. No physical violence. And another thing, dear, keep a careful lookout. There could be more of them about.
Well, there was, down on the beach.
Oh, well, look, don't go near him.
It's a little late for that now, Frank.
What?
It wasn't me. Barry shot his head off. He had the Magnum.
I knew it was a mistake to issue weapons. We're a government department, not a paramilitary unit.
Yeah, the Astro Investigation and Defense Service.
Wish we'd change that name.
Due to the potentially dangerous hazards involved...
All right. At least you managed to convince the minister. Aren't you interested in this Jaguar court, then? Of course we are, Derek.
Right.
Stay where you are, then, and I'll give you an eyewitness description of this intergalactic wanker. Well, I would describe him as sort of human-shaped. He's got jeans and a blue shirt on.
Oh, Christ, he's named the bloody farmer.
Yeah, but there's something strange about him, though. Like he's got a screw loose or something.
It is a bloody farmer.
Yeah, Derek strikes again. This isn't going to be another false alarm like the menace trick invasion alert, is it?
Well, how do you explain the disappearance of an entire township then, Frank?
Oh, the Kiwi Jonestown, of course, that's it.
Drinking beer laced with cyanide from little polystyrene cups.
Yeah. Okay, Derek, just do me one favour.
What?
Try not to make him extinct before we get there.
Out.
Christ, what a dog. How the hell did he get in this team?
Nasty hole in your marrow, mate. We'll get the old ball rolling, eh? Now, what are you dirty hooers doing on my planet? Count of 10. 1, 2, 3, 6, 7, 8, 9,
in.
Thank you.
Thank you. this is going a little bit over the top, Ozzy.
Nah, this'll do the trick. Nobody will be coming out this road.
But the newest nuclear reactor's in America.
Yeah, but it could have been an explosion on one of those Springwatt warships.
Rick! Ozzy! Rick! Ozzy, come in!
Yeah, what is it, Barry?
Jeez, you guys! We're in trouble this time! It's really hit the fan!
Derek's wiped out five of these alien jokers. The place is like a bloody abattoir.
Well, where's Derek now?
Well, he's turned his toes up, guys.
Took a dive off the bloody cliff.
He's popped his rivets.
Poor Derek. Who's gonna look after his Avery now?
Yeah, birds were the only thing he could relate to.
I'm going to head off in the direction that alien joker was going when me and Derek caught him this morning. He must have been going somewhere. They probably got a base up there or something.
They don't need a base. They could just beam themselves down from their spaceship.
Well, maybe they haven't seen Star Trek, Ozzy.
That's my overtime out of today. Here, do you want to do yours?
Hey, Frank.
Yeah, what is it, Barry?
Where exactly are you two?
About 5 miles from Kai Horror.
Yeah, well, just stay put. I think I might have spotted something, and I'm moving in closer.
Finished us?
We've got trouble.
Good one!
Right, we're on our way.
I suppose you're wondering why you're soaking in Reggie-delivered secret herbs and spices. Tomorrow we're having you for lunch. You're the exotic new taste sensation. Human flesh is. You are going to be the first bit of meat that we've had a chance to get our teeth into since we arrived. So we're going to treat ourselves to a feast with you as the main course. Quite an honor, really. We'd better leave, so we can get some sleep. I'll have the edge wrench. I want to suck his brains out. Thank you.
reinforcements.
That'll take a day.
And a rest. Take 2 days to do the bloody paperwork.
Yeah, and by then that collector bloke could be dead.
If he's not already.
Look, go on. After midnight.
Seriously, I think you overdid it with the fog.
Ah, shut up, will you?
Hey there, ghouls. I'm back, and we're trying something a little new here on the movie crypt. As you can see, it's a little foggy in here. A little fog. Get the picture? A little fog. Crying out loud, it looks like a freaking smoker's lounge in here. Hey, anyway, I hope you're enjoying the film Bad Taste. I wish I could say that I was, but I can't even see the freaking movie screen. Anyway, this season is going to be... Good God, that's a lot of fun. This season is going to be a really great one. Of course, a lot of things are happening. We are going to have our annual Halloween special. That's coming up here in a few weeks. Well, Halloween. Of course, on that day, you'll have 24 hours to view our special Halloween episode, which will be this year. It will be Deep Red. So make sure you check that out. And hey, that very Friday is last year's Halloween episode. Bloody Night, Silent Night, Bloody Night. So make sure you tune in for that. And next month is something I'm very much looking forward to, is the 50th episode of Baron Von Gulstein's movie Crypt. Providing the place doesn't burn down first. Anyway, of course, in December, I'm going to have my annual Christmas special of showing Santa Claus Conquers the Martians. Make sure you tune in later. That'll show from Christmas Eve all the way to January 1st. So tune in for that. It's a great way to bring in the new year. And then, you know, this is going to be a great season. So many great movies are coming up. And for you new viewers, thank you very much for tuning in. And for those who have stuck with us from the very beginning, again, much to my burning heart, I thank you very, very much. It means a lot to me that you're still here and you're still watching and enjoying the show and all the craziness that goes around down here. But anyway, enough of that. I'm going to go ahead and let you get back to the feature movie, Bad Taste. I'll see you after the movie, I hope.
Sure, gun to Ozzy.
Yeah, but don't forget about his personality disorder.
Open season on ETs, Frank?
Remember, Ozzy, get in quietly, get out quietly.
Well, I certainly hope that is the case.
Sorry, Oz. We won't be needing that.
Bloody Perry. Oh,
gonna do if we spotted Frank?
Well, I guess we shoot the bastards.
My turn for the Magnum.
I just wish we didn't have to wear all this crap.
Yeah, but you know what the rules are. When we work undercover, we have to remain faceless.
Oh, I get it. Just in case we kill a lot of innocent people.
Don't you forget, Oz, we're only authorized to use violence when there's a threat to the planet Earth.
And the moon?
Yeah, and the moon. There you go, Oz. Stick the stuff on. We ought to have a look around. If these are aliens, they might have parked the spaceship somewhere around here.
They might have come in a telephone box.
Let's just get that guy out. Then we'll try and contact base and give them the code words for invasion.
The bastards have landed.
To be leaving this shitty planet. In the meantime, I must impress upon you the importance of remaining in human form. No matter how awkward, uncomfortable, and ugly it makes you feel, we are so close to success that we must take no chances.
Right. Looks pretty quiet. Probably all gone to bed.
Jeez, I hope not.
Synchronized watch, 12:01. Check. Let's go. We're on triple time.
The sad news is that we will be heading for Neelignod with six of our co-workers in a state of permanent death. They died today, murdered by some real arseholes. Robert escaped their clutches and reported that to me.
Samples to the Neelignod Fast Food Authority. Isn't it amazing how you can fit a whole town of humans into a few cardboard boxes? If you slice off the fat, it's the value of keeping your knife sharp and your mind.
Jesus, guys. Derek was right. This is what's left for the people from Kaihara. They're in those boxes.
Get them, Barry!
For God's sake, guys, keep it quiet.
Shut up, Matthias.
Look, he's cleaning.
Oh, that's gross.
Gee, they come to bits, easy.
Get rid of it.
The old magic's still there.
Thank you.
Frank?
I'm gonna go in there and find out what the hell was going on. Here, he was carrying this. Stay here.
Even the bloody books up, Ned. Last week has been difficult, but I would like to say how proud I am of you all. The manner in which you conducted a very tricky slaughter operation has been a real credit to you. Indeed, to the whole Crumbs Crunchy Delights organization. Your paychecks reflect the gratitude of the company, I can assure you. I don't think we'll have any more trouble. However, we will be handing these around later. I am certain that when the Homo sapient taste takes the galaxy by storm, as it will, Crumbs Crunchy Delights will be back at the top. McYabalo's fried moon rats won't know what hit them. All the livestock we need are right here. 4 billion of them. Right, Robin. Once the Fast Food Authority have checked the samples and issued the mass slaughter permit, this grotty little planet will tremble under the full might of the Lord Crumb restaurant chain. Within a year, the giant mincer will descend from the sky, the sun reflecting from its silver lids, and no army on Earth will be able to stop the nutty burger machine. Before we leave tomorrow, we will have a little party dinner with fresh local meat. It's my show of appreciation to you all.
Christ, you'd never believe what I just had to do.
Did you have to drink some chuck?
Come on, let's find a guy and get out of here.
Good night, Angel. Oh, what a lovely little mossy.
Thanks.
Pictures.
Don't. Come on. How many did you see?
About 8 or 9.
Nah, there's heaps more. That's one less. Ever been in a gun battle before?
No.
Me neither. But this one's gonna be beaut, eh?
Yeah.
Oh.
Bet that cleared his sinuses. Just another beer you owe me, Ice.
That way.
You reckon?
Too right.
Bastard!
Where the hell's Barry?
Thank you.
What's up, Oz?
You go on. I'm gonna go back and stop those bastards.
We're supposed to be going for help.
You go. Besides, you're not gonna be back in time to stop them.
Come on.
Charles Copeland.
Yeah, I'm Barry. Let's go.
Got another one here too.
What goes?
For God's sake, Oz, put that thing down. Let's get in there and hit the leader.
Wait for me!
Here you go, mate. I don't smoke.
Fast.
Spinning steel, shithead!
You gotta be winning. Yuck!
Mine!
Alright there, ghouls, welcome back to Baron Van Goolstein's movie Crypt. I hope you enjoyed the movie Bad Taste. It's one of Peter Jackson's very first movies. I don't think it was his first one. Was it his first one? Anyway, it's Peter Jackson's Bad Taste. Like I said, I wish I could have watched it with you. I watched that before the show aired here. But I wish I could have watched it with you, but I still cannot see the movie screen!
Silence!
With all of this fog. I don't know who's to blame for this, but I'm going to find out, and I'm going to yell at them so this doesn't happen next week. Speaking of next week, make sure you plant your butts right here for next week's episode of an all-new Baron Van Goolstein's Movie Crypt. Hey, and as always, stay cool, ghouls. Crying out loud, that really... Reeks! I'm getting out of there. I need to shave.
Those who worship evil's might, beware my power.